Alright. Alright, we're good. I think we're good. Let's do this nonsense. Hello, Brandon1979. How is it going? Alright. So we finished the main quest last week. So what the deuce are we going to do this week? Well, we want to do the Shivering Isle, but we also got that quest from some rando person that was like, hey! Do this thing I want you to do. This thing. So I guess we're going to go do that, and then... Well, oh, and right. So yeah, this is as well an active quest. I almost wonder if I should just, like, wait this out. I'm never going to remember it, nor am I going to wear it, so screw that. Let's make this our active quest and head for it. Is this where we have to go? I think this is where... Nope. It's back here. It's Trixie. Alright, so it's like this building here. Back to the entrance is like right here. Or is it this? Is the entrance here? Yeah, I think it's this one. I guess I should put my weapons away and not look like a thug.
It's an honor to finally meet you. When I heard you were in town, I just had to send for your help. Your reputation precedes you.
Well, I did... Oh. Like,
allow me to introduce myself. Okay.
I didn't just like moments ago in game time, you know, stop the Oblivion crisis.
Likewise. Sorry to send Gillen's wife to get you in that manner, but it seems safer if we weren't seen on the streets right now.
Why?
If you'll come with me.
What? Okay.
Splendid. Watch your...
You do realize that if you try anything funny, I will just murder all of you.
Assistant and bodyguard.
Like, I'm throwing that one out there. Is if you try any kind of funny stuff, I will murder you. Where are we going? Who are you?
Here at Cyrodiil first.
What is going on?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome. You're now in the sanctuary of the Order of the Virtuous Blood. Few outside our circle have ever set foot in our hallowed hall.
Okay.
We are, for lack of a better word, defenders.
Love of God.
We guard the city.
This is all that this is your vampire hunters?
We are vampire hunters. I'm sure you are familiar with these despicable beings.
Yes, I've killed
feeding on
plenty
the innocent
of them.
As if they were cattle. Well, this group was formed to combat them.
Yeah.
Alas, we are but three old men. Not able
you
to match the
really
fighting
look
prowess
that
of a
old.
Vampire. We lack the strength to defeat them.
Also, there's four of you.
Our goal is to root out the vampires that live in our fair city. So far, we've been unsuccessful finding one. Until now.
Oh my god.
It's come to the Order's attention that Temple District resident Roland Janserik is a vampire. And has already claimed one victim.
I've already killed vampires in this city. I am a better vampire hunter than you.
And cleanse the city of his filth before he can feed or kill again.
God, you people are the worst vampire hunters ever.
A few nights ago, I was roaming the city, as I often do, looking for any signs of a vampire.
You guys are basically hobbyist vampire hunters.
I heard a cry.
Okay.
I rushed into the back garden to find Roland struggling with a woman he'd been courting. I tried to intervene, but he was too strong. He threw his lover to the ground and turned his attention on me.
Oh
luckily,
my.
I managed to run. I hid for a while and then returned to the garden. Roland, that's when I realized he was a vampire. I would start by searching his home. He hasn't been there for days, so it should be safe. His home is located in the Temple District, right across the garden from my...
Uh-huh.
Vampires are you may.
This is all very shady, I'll
who
have you know.
When Roland may strike again, you must hurry.
Okay, well. Let's see what's in your chest, if I can get into it without being seen. No, not easily.
Hello again, fellow vampire hunter.
Seriously, dude, you are fucking
Keep
shady.
Your fingers through-
yeah, I know.
My knowledge? Roland was always a quiet man. It was only It's said that the bite of a vampire has the
Nah, way more than that. I mean, like, really, all that they need to do is just flail at you, and you somehow can, you know, contract it. Maybe it's just them breathing in your general direction.
Is there more?
Okay, so you have nothing to say. Where'd the Argonian go?
You must hurry.
Yeah, well, I don't trust you. So we're breaking into your house. So far, nothing of interest. Don't care. Absorb skill illusion. Where'd the Argonian guy go?
Anything you were...
Yeah, be quiet. I don't want to talk to you. Did he just like? He told me he talked to me afterwards, and then he just fucked off.
Anything you require.
I require to know where your Argonian
Sarah
friend is.
He's asleep right now.
No, he isn't.
He's had a long night of study, and is exhausted. I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. Any new books you've been reading? I've been reading Overview of Gods and Worship. I'm not sure.
Sarador, this guy is not a very good bodyguard for you. I'm throwing that one right out there. Well, let's see
how. Again, fellow vampire hunter.
Yes.
How can I be of A vampire cannot exist in the daylight.
Yeah, I know that.
Roland was very much the loner. Be ever vigilant. Vampires are creatures of deceit.
You guys are all a bunch of racists. I'm just saying, y'all are a bunch of racists. Like, just because they're vampires doesn't make them inherently evil. But I still am gonna break into his house. If I know no one's there, then there could be cool things in here. So clearly, even if I don't know if he's a vampire or whatnot, I'm still gonna like try and steal all this crap. Then we'll head to the Shivering Isles. Unless I find... Ooh, hello. That is a lovely vintage. And some handbills. When you need the best protecting, when you need protecting, where armor made at the best defense. We'll keep you safe from the That's like not remotely even a jingle. People are terrible at writing jingles. I'll take that. Actually, I probably have armor to repair. These are potions of... Oh, and some skooma. Drugs. I like drugs. Gonna take drugs.
It's all over, Lob.
Fuck.
Then...
Hello again, fellow vampire hunter.
Fine, apparently stealing the skooma was a bad idea. You know what? There was nothing in that basement I really cared about. I'm just not even gonna go in there. Like, I got a repair hammer that I used, and that was it. I'll pick the lock to the basement, but that's it. Like, there's nothing else down there. I don't know what got me in trouble with the guards. Oh my god, Mouse Cursor, where are you? Why would a vampire want bread and cheese? Jewelry box, he said. Yeah, that, I mean, like... damage agility and a handbill. Again, a terrible jingle of a handbill. Nothing in the desk. There is, seriously... maybe I can... nope, okay. No. Maybe there's more stuff downstairs. I mean, like, I didn't look for any secret passages. Maybe I should have. Because I am not seeing anything here. I can't interact with that. Interesting. I never noticed that there was, like, space up above some of these things. Let's go look in the basement. Assuming the guards aren't, you know, super zealous about... like, you basically broke into someone's house to say that I was breaking into their house. Just saying. Like, there's nothing in here. Unless it was all a setup or a sting of some sort. I mean, they did seem kind of shady. Well, I guess we'll know if we go back upstairs and there's going to be a guard waiting for us. There's not. Huh. Like, I don't see any evidence that he's a vampire. Like, anywhere. There's nothing under the bed, like, along the bedside, is there? Silver Croft. What's this? It's just a recipe. Who needs a recipe for restore fatigue? I mean, really, that's like the easiest potion to make. Huh. I mean, he does have a lot of skulls laying around, but I don't know if that's that weird, really. Wait, what's this? Oh, those are just blue suede shoes. And a quill. Like, seriously, I'm not seeing... I mean, like, he could be a drug addict. I found skooma in his basement. But that doesn't really mean anything. Like, you can be a drug addict if you want. I mean, I'm not gonna shame you on that. I mean, you should, you know, think about caring about... okay, so that's a shopping list. Why would a shop... why would a vampire have, like, a shopping list for vegetables? This is a very health-conscious vampire, if he's a vampire. Very, very health-conscious. Maybe there's a rack here or something that I can pull out. But I'm not seeing anything. These are just plates to interact with. Again, there's skooma there, but I mean, the last time I tried to steal the skooma, the fuzz was all over me immediately. I'm not doing that again. Nothing there. I mean, like, realistically, this guy seems pretty fucking clean, guys. I mean, if anyone's a vampire, I would say it's the fucking guy that sent me on this quest. I gotta kill him. We'll see if he's a vampire. And then if he's not a vampire, we'll reload and pretend. Well, I mean, like, we won't pretend. It just won't be canon. But, like, there is nothing in his house.
I'm
hey, where are you? I saw you go down here.
Anything you re- is there more? Who knows when Roland may strike again?
Do you not have pointy teeth? I don't know. I'm gonna kill you and see what happens.
Help! Help! I'm being attacked!
Oh, he's unconscious. Well, that's not very interesting. Does he have anything interesting on him? I try to find out if the game would let me.
Is there more? Who knows when Roland may strike again? You must hurry.
Pickpocket! God!
I mean, I'm kind of baffled at this point. What's in this chest? Like, we'll reload afterwards. What is in this stupid chest? Nothing. He didn't even see me, so I don't even have to reload.
Greetings. I'm Sil-
I mean, I guess what we could do is we could go based on the flyers in Roland's house, go to the places that he has flyers for.
How can I? Roland was very much the a vampire. Be ever vigilant. Vampires.
Okay, well, where does he have flyers for? This is like, oh wait, and there's a shopping list. All right, what's the handbill for? Okay, so the handbill is for the best defense. And there's two more handbills downstairs. Oh, there we go. After searching Roland's pound, I found home, I found a love letter written to Roland from his girlfriend. It mentions a cabin where the two would meet. It is located east of the Imperial City in the Great Forest. I think this may be where Roland could be hiding. Alright. So, where is that? Let's go to Wellspring Cave and then travel north. North? Let's travel north from there.
I'm supposed to be impressed!
No, not really. But you did remind me that I don't have my profile set up. I have the wrong profile on. Because I tried to switch spells around and it's nothing. Gotta make sure that, you know, I'm able to swap spells with swap spells with the button on the side of my mouse. This is gonna really start throwing me off because my husband is playing Skyrim Special Edition now. And I've started mixing up in my brain what things you can do in both. Oh, for fuck's sake, wolf! Seriously? Didn't realize that all my soul gems were full, and by all my, I'm probably meaning the one soul gem that I have. Okay, let's put that potato-und. Potato man. Yeah, my brain has already started checking out. Oops. From Oblivion. That has some crazy range on it. So this is going to be a fun 4 final weeks of Oblivion. I think, though, that once I start the Shattering Isles stuff, or Shivering Isles stuff, I'm going to be having some fun. Yeah. Dude, seriously, I closed the Oblivion Gate.
Go away. I know what you're here for. Just leave me alone.
Well, you don't have pointy teeth.
Vampires? Why would you ask me about those filthy creatures?
Cerridor says you're a vampire.
That bastard. Cerridor dares accuse me of being a vampire. Me? Ha! He's the one who is the vampire. I can't believe him. I knew he would try and pin this on me. If only I could get my hands on him.
So we're going to hear the reverse story told this time.
I've been hiding up here in this cabin and I've forgotten my manners. Try and understand.
Oh my god. I don't care. Just...
Ralphina was the love of my life.
Okay.
For the first time I had a positive outlook.
Okay.
Then I saw Cerridor looking at her with those coveting eyes.
Okay.
When she started taking walks in the garden at night, I became suspicious. I didn't want to lose her. I should have trusted her. Oh, Ralphina. Yes, I must let someone else know. That night, I decided to follow. When she stopped in the garden and Cerridor stepped out of the shadows, she seemed entranced as he wrapped his arms around. He became startled for a moment and tossed Ralphina aside. She fell to the ground, and I heard a... I was no equal to Cerridor. He knocked me down in one... Now I know why he didn't finish me that night. I panicked. By the time... They'd never believe he was a vamp.
Okay.
I suppose you must decide what to do.
I'm not gonna kill you.
I know about Cerridor and his secret order. You may want to speak to Phintius at the first edition bookshop in the market district of the city. I doubt that he's told Gillen and Greythrode anything.
Okay.
As you know, the vampire can't remain in sunlight. I'd wager that you...
Exactly. And that's why he sent...
Of Cerridor.
It was so obvious.
You may suspect.
What's in here? Oh. Oh my god, that was so incredibly obvious. Alright, let's zippity-doo-dah back to the Imperial Market District. And wait until it is daytime. Because we gotta go into a shop. And, like, actually talk to people in there, not just, you know, break into it. If all we had to do was break into it, I wouldn't care.
Well met.
Hey.
The thought of what might have happened if you and Martin hadn't stopped Dagon's invasion.
Yeah, no fucking shit.
Thank Akatosh. The Oblivion invasion is over.
Okay, well, Cerridor.
Cerridor? He comes in from time to time. Usually it's when he's out shopping. He always comes in with a large amount of travel food in his bag. Then sometimes he buys a few books. I asked him once. I think I overheard him once mention Memorial Cave to another patron of mine.
Okay.
Yes. It's outside of the Imperial... I just assumed Cerridor had a relative that died and is buried. But Cerridor is a stubborn
one. Okay, so we basically have to go to...
It takes integrity for a man to risk his own life to honor. I looked it up once in an old atlas I had in...
Whatever. You know what? We have vampires to kill. I don't care why I have vampires to kill. I'm just going to kill them. I want to get on to the interesting stuff. And since somebody really, really wanted my help, I guess we're going to go give them my help. I mean, realistically, he's basically signed his own death warrant. This is kind of like a warning to the rest of them. Anyone else that's like coming to ask for me for help and they fuck with me, I'm just gonna murder them. Fucking wolves dodging soul trap, man. It's so annoying. Oh. It's like, what is going on? Oh, right. Also, I'm carrying a bunch of shit. Okay, before I do anything, we gotta go up to... Well, how full are we? Oh, we are quite full. Alright, let's go home first. Let's go drop our shit off and home. Mancor, camera, and staff, that can go stored. I mean, I might want to come back, like, double back on this stuff and sell some of it later, but really, right now, I don't care. Store those. Store any armor that I don't need. Store any ingredients I don't need. We're already like down over 100 pounds or 100 weights of weight. Whatever that unit is, we're down 100. Getting into the heavier stuff now. Okay. What else can we drop? Oh, we got a bunch of spells. By a bunch, I apparently mean like 5 or 6. What else? Anything else that we have that we can get rid of? Give us a little bit more wiggle room for weight. I mean, we've got a bunch of repair hammers, but I don't want to get rid of those. Let's throw that gold in here. Not that I need it for anything, but at the same time, I don't need it for anything, so... Now let's actually go and do a quest. Because yeah, like there's no point in me doing the quest, start doing this quest, which is going to be a dungeon delve. Like I know it's going to be a dungeon delve. So there's no point in me starting it and then realizing, hey, my inventory is full. Let's play the inventory game for the next half hour. Any mud crabs that want to pick a fight? Mr. Mud Crab, die on my sword. Give me your crab meat! I got nothing that rhymes with sword. But I do want your soul. Crab soul. What? Why didn't I get a soul from you? That's lame. It should be like right here, shouldn't it? Ah, here it is, okay. Let's go kill some womp ears. Wow, could you guys not be more obvious? Like, you know, if people were actually coming here for the Memorial Cave, if you didn't have a burning corpse right inside, they might be like, eh, you know what, this is kind of sketchy, maybe I shouldn't. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna give you the benefit of the doubt and then just reload when you attack me.
Whatever it was, it's gone now.
Yeah, I didn't think that I could put vampire souls in anything. But that's okay. I'm wearing Elven Greaves and Glass Cuirasses right now. Oh no, I have an Elven Cuirass, don't I? And I wanted a glass one. Let me see, this one is 9 armor, and this one is 8 armor. Would I hold on to it? And keep going. Oh no! Not a vampire spell sword. No! Greaves actually aren't that heavy. How does a Daedric Greave compare to my spell? Well, I mean, those are heavy though. You know what I should do? I'm gonna grab some and hold on to them for later. Because I suspect this file is gonna live on my hard drive for a while. Or in Steam Cloud or wherever it's got. Who's attacking me? Yeah, don't do that, lady. I'm only gonna grab, like, the Daedric stuff, though, because I don't know if I actually have a spare set of it that doesn't have an enchantment on it, and I would really like the opportunity to put an enchantment on it to up my heavy armor skill, so. I'm just gonna trust that these are all vampires and I should just murder all of them. Felf. I know there's someone else in there. Come out wherever you are. Vampire. Ah, there you are. You'll ever make. There, I've contracted polypyric hemophilia. Luckily, I have cure disease. Fuck! No! 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 Oh, okay. There's someone else here having fun on my behalf. Let's go the fuck up this corridor. Don't give me that you elves are all the same bullshit. Fucking hell. You and your bloody sidesteps, lady. I guess I do them too, though. I'm on a slight detour because that person that was like, that came up to me at the very end of the game, I thought was actually going to give me something important. They didn't. What are you doing? I'm not following you. But I'm finishing the quest to just make sure that, you know, any NPCs that think they can just get my free time by running up to me and being like, oh, come help me. Yeah, no, that's not going to happen. Not gonna happen. I am going to make sure that nobody dicks around with the hero of Kvatch. This is very important. I mean, like, I can't just let them get away with that. Particularly, they're vampires. I mean, like, I'm not racist. I'm not racist like some paladins I know. All vampires aren't necessarily evil. They just have a disease, and it is unfortunate and curable sometimes. If me as a player character can cure vampirism, then you as an NPC can cure vampirism. The more you know. I mean, I know that I can, but still, it's more fun to pretend. We'll see if Nightbot actually is doing what it's supposed to. It's supposed to drop the information about the poll into the chat every half hour if the chat is active. So we'll see if it actually does that. All right. I did cure my polyphyric homophilia, whatever it was. I don't know. Hemo, not homo. Homophilia is something different. We may have contracted that as well, but it is nowhere near as easy to cure, nor do we want to cure it. We're not even sure if it can be cured. It shouldn't be cured. Did you just knock me over with a fucking arrow? Fuck, are we going? Yeah, this looks like a dead end, so we'll go this way now. But I'm gonna head to the Shivering Isles and hopefully things get weird. I mean, I fully expect them to get weird, so, you know. Should be fun. This is more of a minute diversion. Still, like, I've been playing this now for, what, 16, I think this is week 17. I'm still not used to the interface. I still can never seem to remember where things are. Because of the weird, like, nestedness of it. Anyone over there? Oh no, not magic.
No.
Oh. No.
Let's get this.
I love that I'm just basically, like, just standing there letting them shoot me. Be like, guys, like, it's such a Superman moment, right? Where Superman, you know, the scenes, like, where Superman's getting shot with a bullet or something. And he just stands there and lets them shoot him. You know, he doesn't have to be a dick like that. He's probably actually making things worse, considering that the bullets could probably ricochet off of his body and, you know, kill someone. But they never touch on that. Alright, oh, there's a dead... Oh, there's dead bodies hanging from everywhere here, too. I'm never gonna get that skill up, that, like, final level of steel or whatever that is, lockpick. I don't remember specifically what it's called. You don't seem to be able to see me. Because my sneak is that good. And there. I have killed the person that wanted my help because he was being an asshole. Yeah, let's take this stuff. Because glass is... I'm over-encumbered now, though. Glass is the stuff that I want to equip. So let's just pop a potion of feather. Ooh, mark flesh. Any bones? I need bones way less than David Boreanaz does. Is this a dead end? Like, do I have to go back the way I came in? Yep. It looks like there's a complete area I didn't go in, though, so maybe we'll explore that. Should actually check to make sure I didn't catch anything. No. Okay. Well, it's good that we chose the right way immediately, but if we're gonna clear, let's clear. Yeah. I just wanna make sure I have a set of Daedric stuff to enchant if I want to enchant it. Yeah, this is the way we didn't go. Good. Good, 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 because I need charges for my shit. Yeah. Some wolf soul.
Hello? Who's there?
There was another guy over here, but he seems to have fucked off. Oh, there he is. I will say, at least Skyrim, like, the enemies are a lot better at handling the fact that they can't see you. Like, they don't act like they see you, but don't know what to do. Like, they act like they're being hit by someone they don't see. They're really dumb about finding the people. Like, they don't do anything remotely smart to try and come find you. But at least, like, they act like they can't see you. See that doorway. That's gonna be too... Well, no, that's not gonna be too heavy to carry. And this is the end, so yeah. All right, cool. Let's repair our shit, go to Bruma, put our stuff in storage, and then actually go and do what I wanted to do today. This is the wrong pile. This I just did because I felt like I was obligated to follow it through. Because the way that, like, it seemed, the way that I was approached, it really did seem like it was going to be connected to the end of the game, of the previous game, right? Like, I thought, okay, this is quite clearly, like, the way that... Oh, wrong way. This is quite clearly where the game is going as a, like, a post-game quest. But no, it wasn't really a post-game quest. It was a go kill some vampires quest. really, there's nothing else to this other than go kill some vampires for me. Oh, and by the way, I'm secretly the vampire, and, you know, once you meet up with the guy that I said was a vampire, you'll find out pretty immediately that, yeah, he's not a vampire. And it's very obvious that he is not a vampire. But, you know, kill him for me. Okay, I should find something to put... Yeah, we're gonna put in the unenchanted stuff over here. Except for rings. Rings will go back where rings have been going now for a while. Oh, wait. Derp. And the ring goes in here. Go downstairs and drop off the ingredients. And then we're gonna go have some fun. So I've set the poll up for being 4 weeks. Because it seemed like an appropriate time. Because basically it's the first stream of December that we will start. Like, first Tuesday stream. I'm a little heavy. But I'm going to say fuck it and just keep moving. Let's go talk to whatever his face is. Roland. And then let me guess, he's the head vampire! Everyone's a fucking vampire or something. Oh, and his cabin's locked now. That's not suspicious. Roland.
I hope you're here to bring me...
Yeah, Sarador's dealt dead? With.
Oh, thank goodness. I feared I'd never be able to leave here, or worse, that he would come for me. I can finally return home. The ironic thing is that
I think the order of the virtuous
blood should continue its work. Perhaps I'll speak to the others. Yes, I think that the order will live on. Let us never speak of that
So basically,
I'll see you in the Imperial City.
I almost wonder if this is something that was added in the game for after you complete it, because they didn't have like a Vampire Hunter's Guild or something. But I don't see anything here. I like the game's still like telling me to go talk to him, but it's not going to do anything.
Please,
Yeah. All right. Well,
I'll see you in the.
Let's go have some fun, eh? Where is the portal? Here it is.
Stay away from me.
Yes.
How goes it?
There we go. Now, I don't know where we are, if we're even still on Tamriel or not. We could be on some sort of Daedric plane or something. And with all the mushrooms, we could also be in Morrowind. I seriously don't know where we are. The Imion Sea... The Hill of Suicides, the Laughing Coast, New Shayoth. Interesting.
Ha!
Ooh, light for Orca digestive slime. Where? I hear the enemy music. What the fuck are you? Rummite Death Dealer. He seems to be pretty strong to electrical, so. Or it might just be that he has lots of health. Doesn't hit particularly hard. I think he just has a lot of health. Okay, I'm gonna try and soul trap him. I don't know if I can take Grummite souls, but it seems like it's worth a try considering I'm gonna need shards. Or shards, I'm gonna need souls. Ow! Okay, cool. We got the soul. We don't have a body, though. Oh, no. There it is. Okay.
Ow!
Like, I know where everything is in the interface, but my brain, like, it's so weirdly laid out that I just have a hard time with the muscle memory of it. So unless I stop and, you know, actively think about where I need to go in the menu, my muscle memory is just like, click, 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 click. Oh, that's not right. None of that's right. So, I mean, like, they weren't that strong. They were strong, or he was strong, I should say, because there was only one of them. But still, that was a bit laborious of a fight. I wouldn't want to fight more than one of them at once right now. Not without some better gear. And we just, you know, dealt with a bunch of Daedra.
Oh.
Well, now that we know that there are enemies afoot, I should sneak. It's getting a stealth start to the fight. What's that over there? It doesn't seem to be anything. That's good, at least. There's like a cave up here? Big map. Okay, so we're still inside the fringe. Now, I maybe actually should go find the Shivering Isle quest and activate it. It's gonna be an older quest. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Here we go. Found Gardens of Flesh and Bone. Well, those look like chupacabra. And those look fucking terrifying. Yeah, no shit. Okay, I need to soul trap this here in a second. And hopefully I can get a soul from it. Good. I don't want them to come near me. They look like they're gonna just wreck my face off. Alright, I need to soul trap here in a minute. So I'll swap that over. They were fresh enough to have marrow, which is kind of terrifying. Is a bone shard an ingredient? Okay, yes. Like, basically, Sheogorath, whose realm this is the danger of madness, right? So, it's kind of expected that this is going to be a little weird. I think it's because it can't... Oh, shit. It can't reach me from either side. I mean, at this point, also that I'm doing the game, my skills are pretty decent. Oops, that's not what I meant to cast. I'm perfectly fine with being Cheater McCheatington if this is considered cheating. But I don't see how this could be ever considered cheating. I mean, yeah, the AI is dumb, but like, I'm not doing anything that isn't within, like well within the bounds of what you can do in the game. I mean, there's even a point in the game where they give you boots so you can jump higher to get on top of something. So, it looks like the gatekeeper skeleton I have to do something with that I can't do yet. And I'm guessing he opens the door. Okay, that makes sense. And is there anything else here? I mean, like, that's my guess, at least. I think it's a pretty reasonable guess. Why are those things? Like, seriously, those look like chupacabra. Or at least, like, a stereotypical, you know, representation of what a chupacabra would look like if, you know, chupacabra exists. Alright, so it doesn't look like there's anything I can do over here at the moment, unfortunately. But, I mean, I kind of expected that. We were wandering towards a place where we weren't being told to go, and often you'll either find somewhere you can go, but really don't need to, or find somewhere you need to go, but can't yet. And this is falling into the latter category. Occasionally, though, there are cases where you get to go and, like, get the quest stuff all in advance, and then you just have to be like, hey, yeah, that thing you sent me to get? Yeah, I already have that. Here, let's keep this train rolling. Okay, there was like a cave. Okay, no. It was the Gardens of Flesh and Bone that for some reason are shown as a cave on the map. I don't know why, but they are.